Welcome to this new video about Semantic Kernel, in which I start describing a more advanced way to interact with a large language model using plans. To start, we need to understand the differences between using a standard React framework and a plan. In this slide, I show how the React framework works. It is basically based on a sequence of interaction to a large language model where you start with a question of the user and you ask to the large language model, here, these are the tools I can use. This is the user question. What do I do next? Usually, the large language model answers with, okay, I have the answer. I don't have the answer, or you need to use these tools. Usually, the third answer is the more common. So, step by step, the large language model tells you which tool you need to use. You extract parameter from the prompt response. You invoke the tool. The tool gives you some output, and you return to the large language model for the next interaction, adding the new result as observation. So step by step, the large language model guides you to solving the user question with the tool you have. This approach usually has, in my opinion, some disadvantages. First of all, you don't know in advance if you're going to find a solution. The large language model proceeds step by step, but it is possible that after some interaction, it just gives you, I cannot proceed, I don't have an answer. And this is annoying if you are using plugin that require resources, because as you see in my previous example, I have a plugin that from an audio file extract the text with OpenAI Whisper, and this consumes GPU cycle. So if at a certain point the React tells me to extract the text from the audio, I'm paying that call, and maybe further on in the process, it tells me that it cannot proceed. And this is especially annoying if we are using tools and plugin that change the state of the system. So we start changing the state of the system, and then we can find a moment in which a large language model told us, hey, I don't have a solution, but you already execute some of the steps. To solve this problem, Semantic Kernel has an experimental feature using HandleBars Planner, and Planner were used in the previous beta version, but now it's changed a little bit. Now the Planner is contained into the HandleBars Planner. You need to use a pragma instruction to reassure the compiler that you know you're using an experimental feature. And then it is really simple, because as you can see in the code, I'm simply creating a planner. Then I simply create a question from the user. And then I use the create plan async to create a plan. And after this, I'm only printing the plan and printing the number of interaction I had with my large language model thanks to my debugger. As you can see, the interaction with the large language model is require only one call. After you call the create plan async, the large language model answer you with an handlebar template, and handlebar is it's a special syntax to create templates. And as you can see in this picture, it actually answers you with the whole plan. So my question is, I want to have a summarized timeline of a video, and it correctly determined that thanks to my available plugin, I need to call three plugins in sequence: extract audio, extract text from audio, and create a summary from the text extracted from the video. And this is really important for a couple of reasons. First of all, I've only made one call to the large language model to have the answer. And then before actually invoking any plugin, I have the whole plan. So I can present to the user, I can format this and present to the user and tell to the user, hey, the system is going to do this thing to satisfy your question. Do you want to proceed? And this solves the problem of going step by step in interaction, like we did in the React with the React framework, and we can find the moment in which the large language model tells us, I don't know how to proceed. Now, with this kind of interaction, the large language model tells immediately if it finds a plan that we can use to solve the solution, or we cannot have a plan to solve the solution before actually invoking any of the plugin. As you can see, I've dumped in the console the whole plan, so the user can see what's going to be executed. And I've pointed out that I had only one call to my large language model. So I have a single call to have this plan. And this is usually faster than proceed by step. But remember, this kind of interaction require a large language model that can have a good capacity of analyzing the text. So probably you will need GPT-4 to solve some complex problem. While with React, proceeding step by step, probably GPT-3.5 is enough. But in this situation, I need only one call, so it's usually fast and I don't need a lot of token because I have only one call. Now, if you are curious, thanks to the code that I wrote to intercept the large language model call, this is the prompt that it's actually using. Clearly, it is not easy to look at the prompt inside the Visual Studio because it has some formatting issue. So it is better to copy, paste into some other editor and make some replacement to have a better idea of what the prompt is. Actually, the handlebar planner can dump the prompt for you even with a nice property called prompt, but thanks to the interception of the whole HTTP call, you are able to intercept everything. And this is a better formatted version of the prompt in which you see that it starts with an example because, as you know, zero-shot prompt does not work well. So the prompt starts with an example. If the user wanted you to generate 10 random number and blah, 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 it is guiding the large language model into answering what you are expected to. So it is guiding the large language model into answering you with a plan. And then at a certain point, the prompt starts including your plugin, the plugin you define it. So the large language model can understand which are the tools it can use to solve the plan. And actually at a certain point in the prompt, it will enforce the large language model not to use anything else, but only the plugin that the user defined. So it does not need to use anything else. So you are sure that the plan contains only calls to your plugin. As usually, you can understand that now all the plugins are described in text format. It does not use the function options of GPT. And this because I'm not asking for a single function call, I'm asking for a plan. So everything is textual. As you can see, it is really important that you describe your plugin well because all the description of your plugin and the parameter of the plugin are included in the prompt and are used by the large language model to understand how you need to use this plugin. So it is important that the description is good, written in a clear and conscious English. And then you can see the answer. Now, as you can see, the answer contains the real handlebar templates in a section divided by three ticks like markdown, because this is essentially markdown. And then you have also in the bottom a description that states this template does the following. And this text is not extracted by the plan, but you can extract if you want. It can give a better information to the user. And I hope that in a future version of the handlebar templates, the parser will not only show you the plan, the part included inside the triple tick section, but it will give you also the English translation of what the plan is going to do. So it will set the path to the video file, extract audio from the video file, and blah, blah, blah. And this describes basically the sequence of steps you need to perform with the plugin to execute the plan and solve the user question. Now that you have a plan, the only thing you need to do is call the invoke async of the plan object, passing the kernel you want to use. So you can pass a kernel that has GPT-3.5 or it has GPT-4. But basically, if you only need to invoke plugin that does not require interacting with a large language model, actually, this is the moment in which Semantic Kernel start using your plugin. And you can see that actually I got my answer. I got my summarized timeline, and also I have an information that I needed only one more call to large language model to solve this problem. And the call is required by the summarizing plugin that is using GPT-4 to pass the complete transcription of the video and ask GPT-4 to extract the major section. So everything works as expected with only two calls to a large language model, opposite to the previous example where we use React and we need maybe four or five calls to solve the same problem. If you want to verify that indeed the second call to the large language model was not part of Semantic Kernel, but it's my plugin, I just dump the content. As you can see, is my plugin. I will give you a transcript of a video, blah, blah, blah. It's one of the plugins that you can write in Semantic Kernel, specifying only the prompt and the parameters. To have a recap, the approach using a plan instead of standard React, it usually requires a more powerful large language model, but it gives you immediately with a single call upfront the sequence of steps you need to do, and it immediately gives you the idea if the information if you can solve the task or you cannot solve the task. And then when the plan is approved, you can show it to the user. You need only one call to execute, and if all the operation you are executing with the plugin can be put in a transaction, like in .NET with a transaction scope, you can also execute the whole plan in a transaction. And this is especially important if you are using this to orchestrate call to your system and you are modifying the state of a system. So you want that either everything goes well or everything is rolled back. So if you are interacting, as an example, with a database, you can open a transaction, execute all the command with that transaction, and if there's an exception, you can always roll back. And this is very, very powerful. It's a thing. It's something you cannot do if you are using the React approach, because the React, you can put everything in a transaction, even in a React, but usually you have a lot of interaction with large language models, so the transaction will span for too much time and it's not so useful. And this concludes this video about Semantic Kernel and Handlebar Planner, in which you saw how you can solve a user question with a powerful tool that is a planner that can immediately ask to the large language model, tell me everything I need to do to solve the user question. So you immediately have your plan and you can execute. And this is a really powerful option, and you can always choose between the standard React or this more advanced way to solve a user problem. I hope you like this video, and I'm waiting you to the next one. Bye-bye.